The first scenario is the typical case in which it is recommended to use the extract method refactoring, when there is duplicated code in two or more methods, and we want to take this code, factor it out, and basically have the two methods called a third method, which is the one that we create using the refactoring. When a class is too large, normally we don't want to apply the extract method. Instead, in these cases, it is usually more appropriate to use the extract class or extract subclass refactorings. Analogously, when the names of two classes are too similar, extracting a method will normally not help much. And all we need to do, in case having two similar names is actually a problem, is to rename one of the two classes, or both, if we wish. Finally, it is definitely appropriate to apply the extract method refactoring in cases in which a method is highly coupled with a class other than the one where it is defined. In this case, which we will discuss also later in the lesson, the extract method refactoring allows us to extract the part of the method that is coupled with the other class. Then we can take the method that we just extracted and move it to the class where it actually belongs. So the extract method is one of the two refactorings that it is appropriate to apply in these cases.